All right, what's going on, you guys? Nick here with Nick Strength and Power. I've got a couple of interesting stories for you guys today. I'm sure a lot of you guys already know what the first story is going to be about today. And that is Keon Pearson's recent guest posing video that he posted to his Instagram from the NPC Memphis Bodybuilding Championships. So a couple things I wanted to talk about with this posing routine. Number one, Keon is about 15 weeks out from the Chicago Pro, where he's going to be trying to qualify for the 212 Olympia yet again. And that's going to be on July 23rd through 24th in Atlanta, Georgia. And in this posing video, that puts Keon about 13 weeks out from the Chicago Pro. Now, this video almost made me wish that we got to see Keon stay in the classic physique division, because I really enjoyed Keon's posing here. Keon did a really good job of hitting some classic poses, really smooth transitions between poses for this routine. And I was actually very impressed. So on one hand, while I think, I've said this before, I think he was perfect for classic physique. I think he could have put on a little bit more size and been very competitive in classic, but I think he's doing well in 212. Actually, that's not just a matter of my opinion. He is doing well in 212. He already won the Chicago Pro when he made his 212 debut there last year. So he is a good fit for 212. I personally think he's going to win the 212 Mr. Olympia one day, but it's kind of bittersweet to see, because I think he was so good in classic. He had such a classic structure. He had such good genetics, such a good physique for that division. I really loved Keon in classic. But at the same time, all those great classic attributes that Keon has, the small waist, the V-taper, the vacuum pose, the posing, it's nice and refreshing to see him bring that over to another division like 212 and still be able to do well in that category. So I kind of like that too. You also get to see the size that Keon has put on. We've talked about this ad nauseum. How many times have we said Keon's put on more size for 212? He's put on size, it's obvious. But because we are getting closer to that Chicago show, he's actually looking like he's in pretty good shape. He's not looking fat. He's not looking watery. He's not looking bloated. He's not looking super off-season. Like I said, he's about 13 weeks away from having to take the stage in Chicago. And honestly, man, I'm just really impressed, and I'm really excited to see what the future holds for Keon. I hope he's going to win the Chicago Pro. I don't know who else is doing the 212 category in Chicago. We know that we've got Akeem and Hunter and Charles Griffin and Sergio Jr. All those guys are doing men's open in Chicago. I don't know who's doing 212. But my money for this one, my money's on Keon. I want him to win this show, qualify for the Olympia, and I want to see Keon versus Sean Clarita as 1 and 2 on the 212 Olympia stage. I think that would be good for Keon, because I think Sean's crazy conditioning would really push Keon to take his conditioning to the next level to be competitive with Sean Clarita. When Derek Lunsford first hit the scene, I thought Derek had some of the best genetics in 212. I would argue that Keon has better genetics than Derek, better legs than Derek, and I guess we'll see when it comes to conditioning, because conditioning seems to be what has caught Derek slipping. I think Derek and Keon are very similar. They've got the small waist, they've got the V-taper, they've got the vacuum pose with the front double, super wide lats. But conditioning seems to be what really caught Derek lacking. And we'll see if Keon is able to overcome that curse. But let me know what you guys think in the comment section below about Keon Pearson, Chicago Pro, 212. How's he going to do? And is he going to make it to the Olympia in 2021 for 212? But shout out to Keon, man. I got a lot of faith in this guy. Now, next up in the news, I wanted to show you guys the remainder of the IFBB schedule for the year. Because keep in mind, guys, we're getting to such a late start for the year that the season doesn't start until May. So that's next month, and then the qualification ends in October for the Olympia. So you've got a very short span of time, less than 6 months, to compete and qualify for the 2021 Mr. Olympia this year. But that being said, as bodybuilding fans, we've got a lot to look forward to this coming summer. So the first show is the Indy Pro. That's coming up in about 2 weeks. Next show you got is the New York Pro. That's coming up in about 3 weeks. You got the Cali State coming up at the end of May. You've got the Yamamoto Nutrition Puerto Rico Pro. That's coming up at the end of June, it looks like. So there's not a whole lot in June besides that. So between the California State and this Puerto Rico Pro, there's not a whole lot going on. You got this Mr. Big Show that's going to be mid-July. You've got Pittsburgh Masters. So then you've got Chicago Pro, which is late July. You've got Tampa Pro, which is early August. And then the Texas Pro, which is mid-August. Then you've got the Europa Pro, which is going to be in Spain. So that's the Alicante Spain show. And that is going to be in mid-August. And then late August, Toronto Pro, KO Pro Men's Open, the Ben Weider Natural. I don't think there's Men's Open Bodybuilding there. And then that's really pretty much it. You've got the Arnold Classic UK, which is the week before the Olympia, but that's a qualifier for 2022. So I think the last qualifier for a men's open bodybuilder would be, I guess, this KO Pro, which I'm not too sure what that is, but I'm thinking the Toronto Pro is going to be the last one that we're really familiar with as far as a big qualifier for the Olympia. So Toronto Pro looks like that's about the end of the road. So it is definitely going to be a jam-packed summer, guys, of bodybuilders trying to qualify for the Olympia. So make sure you subscribe to this channel and stay tuned because we got a lot of coverage to talk about coming up. Now, next up in the news, the Rolly Winkler guest posing. I've got some brand new information about that Rolly Winkler guest posing that happened this weekend. The Emerald Cup Pro, where Rolly did a guest posing. I actually talked to Rolly on Instagram last night. So the interesting thing about that guest posing was that Rolly has not trained at all in 7 weeks leading up to that guest posing. So the physique that you saw from Rolly, he has not even been training for almost 2 months. So he messaged me. He said, "Hi, bro. I see you talk about me on YouTube. I don't training. My country have lockdown. Yesterday, I see a gym after 7 weeks." So he's saying the first time that he trained was yesterday. That's the first time in 7 weeks because his country is locked down. He hasn't even been able to go to the gym. So I said, "Ah, okay. Thanks, bro. Are you planning on any shows?" And he says, "Sorry, I landed late. Just landed in Miami." And he says, "I can't train, so I can't choose a show." So it does make me wonder if that possibility of a special invitation to the Olympia is on the table. If he's not able to train because of lockdown for one of these qualifier shows, that could certainly be an extraordinary circumstance that prevents him from competing that might be worthy of a special invitation. However, I suppose there's also the possibility that he's not able to train all the way up until the Olympia, so he might not even be able to train for the Olympia itself. But I gotta say, looking back at the video of Rolly from this guest posing, he looks pretty damn impressive for a guy that hasn't trained in almost 2 months. So that just goes to show you what a freak of nature Rolly is, that he looks that impressive and he's in that good of shape to do a guest posing without any training at all for 7 weeks. But it really does make me wonder whether or not we're going to see him on the Olympia stage in October if he's not able to train. I mean, what's he gonna do? Let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. Is that worthy of a special invitation? Should he get one? Do you want to see him? I certainly want to see him on the Olympia stage. I missed having Rolly there in 2020. I want to see him there in 2021. Now, next up in the news, we've got Hunter Labrada looking absolutely ready for war at the upcoming Chicago Pro. He's 13 weeks out right now. His latest physique update, you can see quite a good glimpse of how he's looking. And that Olympia qualification this year for Hunter is not going to be easy. The Chicago Pro is going to be stacked. You got Akeem Williams, you got Sergio Oliva Jr., you've got Charles Griffin, you've got Hunter. There's going to be some really good guys in this lineup. So if Hunter does earn his qualification there, it's going to be a hard-fought and a well-earned qualification because that is going to be a tough lineup for a relatively newer pro like Hunter. And this is kind of why I showed you guys the schedule earlier in this video, because I want to make it clear there's not a lot of shows between now and the Olympia to qualify. That's why you've got these crazy stacked lineups. It's looking like there's not going to be an Arnold Classic USA this year. That's how it's looking, and that's typically how a lot of points are earned. That's how a lot of people qualify for the Olympia that are like big name, like second tier bodybuilders. I hate to say it, it's sad to say it, but it looks like that Arnold Classic is not happening. So there's not a lot of opportunity. So if Hunter waits till Chicago and he doesn't win there or get enough points there, there's not a whole lot of opportunities between Chicago and the Olympia to make it. So what you might see this year is a smaller Olympia lineup, or at least see a lot of familiar names missing from the Olympia lineup this year because the opportunities are just not that many. And the amount of time is very short. May to October is not a lot of time. So like I said, man, you got to stay tuned to the channel. There's going to be some battles this summer for that Olympia qualification. I mean, it's going to be intense. And the final story that I have for you guys today, I wanted to cover the kind of end phase of Seth Ferrosi's transformation. He's been doing this transformation lately. You guys seen the amazing results that he's had with that. He talked about how he wasn't on a lot of gear. He was just on a low dose of TRT. But the final stage of that transformation was shaving off all that body hair. So I wanted to show you guys this recent post from Seth Ferrosi that seems to be the final stage in his transformation. And he's looking damn good, man. I've said this before. You guys know. I would like to see Seth compete just one last time. Seth has made it perfectly clear that he's not going to make a comeback to bodybuilding. He's not going to do it. I still would love to see it. I'm a sucker for comebacks, but in either case, shout out to Seth. Continued source of motivation for a lot of guys out there. So again, just shout out to Seth. That's going to wrap it up for the video, guys. I hope you did, in fact, enjoy it. Please give it a thumbs up if you did enjoy it. Please subscribe to the channel if you have not subscribed yet already. As always, I love you guys. Appreciate you guys. Nick Strength and Power signing out.